you two, and welcome to episode 2 of After Story Podcast. My name is Kevin Talent, AMVs, and hope you guys enjoy.
Hello, YouTube, and my name is Ruiz Wise, and I mean, of course, enjoy the video.
All right, so let's pick up the conversation where we left off before the recording started.
Yeah, Hey, Kevin, do you remember actually in the last podcast what you said about the Dragon Ball Z?
Oh, I said that hang on, I honestly forgot what I said.
Should actually go like and die and like rest in peace because they're milking it and that. Remember now?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, I should really know what I said. Yeah.
Oh yeah. So guess what? There will be a new Dragon Ball series, which is called Dragon Ball Super,
aka GT son-in-law, but still.
not technically, because the story will be written by Akira Toriyama, so it is canon. It is like legit now.
Well, all I gotta say that he better not mess it up, because I'm pretty a fan of Dragon Ball Z, and I really think that he shouldn't make another series, because it's been going on for all these years, and he wait till like right 2015 to make another series. I guess I don't really know what he was waiting for, but it seems that
money. I think it's money. To be honest with you, I mean it's like money, and that's it. I think it's for business and for money purposes.
Yeah, it could be that too, but since the movie Resurrection of F Frieza and all that, I heard that it did pretty good. It
in Japan, I think it like sold over 8 million yen or something like that.
Yes, yeah, so I guess he sort of got back into the whole anime process. Oh, I make a movie, then that did pretty well. So I guess I can just like start it back up again, you know, make a whole new series.
But this is the thing, because I actually saw on other code that actually it would be other manga with some other mangaka who would actually be doing the story. So I don't know how is it going to go. Like, is he gonna do like in different time, or is it gonna be at the same time? Anime and manga, like, because it's really confusing me right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
here's the thing, like, I think that Toriyama should really focus on the seven universe thing that he mentioned in Battle of Gods.
Yeah, I guess that sort of like foreshadowed that there's going to be a new series to explain the whole seven universes and the whole other gods. Yeah, so I guess if he does that, we're looking at more than 100 episodes probably.
No. I really think Dragon Ball Super should be like seasonal, but like 50 episodes. Like 50 episodes every two seasons.
Yeah, I can see that. Instead of not following the like the regular route for like shonen, which is like every mostly every week.
Yeah.
Instead of doing seasonal, but that's a possibility.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Now he could actually bring a filler character that. And of course, you know what everybody wants. Who everybody wants to be canon now. Like, he has the option to actually bring Broly to be canon. And wants Broly to be canon.
Mm-hmm.
He can actually do that now, which I think would be great, because Broly, if you remember from the movie, he really was like unstoppable, like nobody almost could stop him. So if I wonder if you would actually make him a canon. So I wonder how Toriyama would actually handle him.
Yeah, if he do that,
interesting. If he would do that.
I think if he did, he gotta make him stronger than he was before, because since right after the Buu saga, like Goku, Vegeta, and all of them like pretty strong.
God,
and
yeah.
During the movie,
yeah,
they're like
Super Saiyan God.
Yeah, they're around like a super like Super Saiyan 1 or 2. So
yeah.
If you just make Broly stronger, then yeah, it's okay to add him in there.
Yeah. So what is actually my theory about it, that I think Toriyama should actually bring like Broly from other universe, who actually have almost like all the powers, he like have a Super Saiyan God or something. Then you would be like on the same level of Goku and Vegeta.
Yeah. Only thing that I don't hope he do for the animation, you know how Dragon Ball Z is like notorious for like stretching out the fights to like 10 to 15
yeah.
episodes for no reason. If they make the
yeah.
fights like quicker and more like up to pace, and that'll be fine. Instead of
do you remember what anime studio is actually now doing Dragon Ball Z? Do you remember who is doing Dragon Ball Z? Toy Animation. Do you think that they will make a faith-based anime? No, they won't. They're like doing with One Piece. They're doing one episode, one chapter. It was another thing that actually took almost all the community once again. And of course, it was fairy fairy tale, which I have to call it a fairy shit, which was again Hiro Mashima bring another bad bullshit chapter with Natsu, one shot a god, and then the whole YouTube anime community is like, oh my god, he did it again.
Yeah, I was thinking about that for like 2 days. I think the reason was, I don't even know the story was happening right now, but I think he just did something totally like epic, just because to catch up to what like the Naruto and what One Piece are doing. Because I heard that with One Piece, Luffy unlocked a Gear 4, so everybody's talking about that. And Naruto just came back with the side chests of Boruto, Sarada. And now I guess
yeah.
he probably see, oh, they're talking about this. I'm gonna make some something that's like,
bullshit.
Yeah, some bullshit thing, and make Natsu defeat a god like in one punch, so everybody can talk about that. But which it was like
yeah.
a really bad idea on his part, because how can he's like a normal person, this is got trained by a dragon or something, and out of nowhere he can defeat gods with one punch. That's like, what?
Lazy writing, it's lazy storytelling, it's bullshit, and I don't get why people still care about fairy tale, because fairy tale is it, and that's it.
Mm-hmm. It doesn't really have a main story, just have arcs. So how long is this gonna continue on, really?
Yeah, it's like, who cares anymore about fairy tale? I don't know why fairy tale fans care about the story, because there is no story. There is a bit now from what I can hear, like there is something now with Zeref and that, but it's like, it doesn't matter. It's too late now to fix anything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, since the show also is not going anywhere, people say, oh, you gotta wait till some arc is coming up right now, and they always say, oh, wait till this arc is gonna be the best. And I probably won't even watch it, because the last arc with the dragons coming out of the gate portal future thing, whatever that was, I like, come on, like, and Gray ended up dying somehow, came back to life because of some girl, and I like, what is he doing? The story is making no sense at all, and I just like lost interest.
Oh, so you actually watch the anime, like, arc. There is another arc that coming up next that really taking a seat on every hype that Fairy Tail fan had, like really taking a seat.
Yeah, it just gotten boring. I used to enjoy it before the that little break that they had with the fight with Hades and went to the island. I really enjoyed that and the little time skip that they had.
Yeah, because Fairy Tail was fun at that time. It wasn't taking itself seriously and nothing. It was like a typical shonen that you can watch and entertain, but then you realize what is doing the same thing every arc. So it's like, no, that it's lazy storytelling. Really lazy.
It's like the whole thing with the cliche thing. They meet a new person, and they drag the story out. Meet new character, talk, talk,
Yeah.
talk. A little fight here and there, and then at the end, Natsu or somebody, like,
Flip to power up.
yeah, power up and then defeat him, and then asking him to go back to comedy, have a good laugh, and just get and to do the
Oh,
same thing
and
over and over
boobs
again.
and boobs.
Yeah, it's gotten really boring.
Boobs. Yeah. Yeah, anyway, but yeah, that's it, yeah, Fairy Tail, you see it, let's move to the next topic.
Since more episodes came out for the new 2015 spring
Yeah.
season, I have yet to watch a new episode of Ori Monogatari, but I saw the last episode when the building caught fire and he saved the
Oh,
girl's
listen.
friends.
You have to catch up to it. Listen, the last episode, the last 5 minutes. Oh my God. No,
Okay.
it was comedy gold, like comedy fucking gold.
Because I'm really enjoying that show right now.
It's really good. It's really that is a good romance and unique one, I think. For me, I think it's unique. Like I can see some people hate it for like maybe like it's too fast and that like maybe they're doing it too fast. I can see some people hate it, but like for like if you watch any anime romance like any couple in anime, it will take them like one season to actually say, oh, I actually love you.
Yep,
It will
and
take them
the credits go
one
up.
season. Yeah.
See, now they are making the next level of romance instead of, I don't know, it's not going too fast. It's like the right amount of pace. He saved her from the molester on a train, and then a little small build up here and there, and she didn't wait like a million episodes to tell how she felt about him, which was like really nice. And that's
Yeah.
one of the things I enjoy about the anime.
Yeah. Okay. So to actually summarize all of it, Montagu, it's like the best romance for now for 2015. For now, yeah. Okay. So next anime is Punchline.
Yeah, I watched I'm on the third or fourth episode right now. I don't really know what the full story is as of yet, but I'm just wondering, it's one of those where you just sit back and relax, and if something happens, then you'll be still in tune with it. But it's still like an enjoyable show to sit back and relax on. Like when you have free time, you just end up watching it.
Yeah, I'm only on episode 2 because I don't know. I don't feel like watching right now because like as you said, I can watch it anytime on any episode and I'll be like caught up to it. and Finn be like, oh, it's okay, and I can actually watch it from there, from next episode in there, right?
Yeah, you probably won't miss anything major.
Yeah,
because like people
yeah,
won't
me too.
be like either. Cause not, I haven't really been seeing any buzz about it on online that much. So they probably won't be spoiling anything unless something like, really crazy happens.
Yeah. So, Punchline as a whole is it's like a fun, it's like a fun anime that you can watch anytime and at any episode. Basically, okay. So next anime is Trigger X. Listen, I dropped it because I don't know. It's not for me. It's almost like a High School of the Dead, but worse.
Yeah.
For me. I don't like it.
I try to get into it. I saw the first episode and the second episode. I just like since High School of the Dead. The reason I don't really like it that much is because they're normal high school students and they just stick to that role instead of becoming like these experts in zombie killing. And that's why I sort of stopped watching the show. So I try to, since it's from the same creator, I probably think, oh, he's probably going to do some above and beyond thing again. But then instead of normal high school students, he went to some group or whatever. And the second episode is really why I was... what happened? They tried to save the girl who got kidnapped from the, some gang, and they went to the building, they raided the building, and then there's one scene when the girl stops a car with this big ass shield, and the car like flips over, and this girl like slices the car in half. I'm just sitting there like, really?
Yeah.
Like, I know like something's like some bullshit thing's gonna happen, but, like really that's what they're gonna go with it, but I guess.
No, I'm like. I don't like it because it's like High School of the Dead as actually a story is shit, but the characters actually make it more enjoyable. But these characters, like a Tiger X, they don't make it enjoyable. It's like, no. It's like you are all generic ass characters.
Yeah, so especially it. The mate of the guy. He just like shows no emotion or anything.
It doesn't show emotion, but of course people say, wait more episodes, like the development will maybe come in that. No, for me it's like no, I don't want to wait for that show to like me. Like the first episode, it really matters. For an anime to make it an impact on you.
Yeah.
And I'm sorry, it didn't make an impact. It didn't.
I guess the guy, he tried to make a comeback, but it's just one of those shows that you can just skip. You won't really miss anything.
Yes, yeah, skip it and that's it. That's it, basically. Yeah, so, yeah, of course, and now we should talk about the new Naruto chapters.
Yeah, I really enjoy chapter 3.
Chapter 2 and 3, they were good, but it's like the old characters like Naruto, Sasuke, Sakura, Ino. I know it's all about the new generation with Boruto and Sarada, but like, the characters like Naruto and Sasuke, they not act like what you actually thought they could act. Like with Sasuke, he's like, oh, Sasuke, I'm like a daughter? What is a daughter? I really don't know what Kishi is actually doing with Sasuke and Naruto, like as both of our fathers.
Yeah, I hope he doesn't really forget about him since he really is on the next generation, but I just don't want him to be, like, really bad side characters. I want them to have, at least, like, have, like, a little training montage or something.
This, I think, will be probably, in the new movie, in the new upcoming movie.
Yeah, I hope, since maybe the movies are probably going to be the last thing, Maybe or maybe not, but I hope it doesn't, the movie doesn't ruin it. I don't want to
Yeah.
become like too fast paced since they just released the new villain. We don't really know his name, but you've seen like a little bit of his face. And so
I think people say it's like a Yamato, or it's like or it's like a Madara who actually somehow brought back to life again.
yeah, I think is there like a reincarnation sort of kind of like a Ten-Tails thing, because it's still like the little small like Ten-Tails thing watching Sarada in the forest.
Yeah.
So I think it's like the guy came from the Ten-Tails, like a little Zetsu, and he formed together or something.
Maybe that actually could make sense, because we see his eyes, and it's like Sharingan. It look like it actually got attached to him, like somebody put those eyes inside of him.
Yeah, and
So,
it seems to have a lot of information about like both
Matias.
Naruto, yeah, Chiyaz and Naruto. So
Yeah,
since
and then we got a scene Uchiha, like the kid, which is weird because he look like Mitsuki and Tonere. He look like them, but he have a Sharingan, so I really don't know what is actually up with him.
Yeah, but overall, as of the three chapters right now, it's getting pretty good.
It's fun. It's like giving you a part one like feelings again. Like yeah, it's like part fun. Like we have teamwork with Zozo and Sarada. Like how they team up to actually hold up against Sin.
Yeah, I guess and they're not really showing that much of Boruto in the manga, so I guess they're probably gonna wait till like the full movie to come out to show its full colors.
I think in the movie there will be like the full action and more epic stuff. I think now it's more like of a setup. I mean it is a setup, but you know what I mean. Yeah. But overall, I really wish that Kishimoto won't forget about the old characters, because I don't like how Naruto and Sasuke act like fathers. I don't like it.
Like, knowing from them how they don't really have any parents, they should just they shouldn't act like well, Naruto doesn't have any parents because since they passed, but he still met him though. But I guess he shouldn't be
Yeah.
like not really with Boruto. He should be like with him more instead of just abandoning him. Doing I understand he's the Hokage and all, but still, like that's your son, you know.
Yeah,
And
but
like Sasuke is doing Sasuke.
Sasuke is even more worse. He's like, oh, the other like, no, I'm actually going to go outside of the village, like, for 11 years, and that, like, daughter, no, I don't care about her. It's
Sasuke is
like,
my favorite character. I just want to try to defend him. Like he's outside working, you know, risking his life to save the village, but
but still,
yeah, he's just
like,
not there.
really, like, 11 years, can't you even, like, one time to come and visit the village and like, go back? Like, one time?
Yeah, he really needs like a really big explanation. But since I'm a huge Sasuke's fan, anything he say, I believe him.
Yeah, me too, but still, it's still like Sasuke. What you do right now is ruining your character motivation. What happened part two and that.
Yeah, but it's a good thing that Sarada doesn't hate him though. Like she really loves him. Like, good thing that she doesn't really hate him, or else it's gonna be just another Sasuke having hate all the time and all that. But you know.
Yeah. Yeah, luckily. Yeah, luckily. But anyway, yeah, I think it's enough for Naruto. I think Naruto overall, Naruto Gaiden, it's really good. It's really fun to read.
Yeah.
But the characters need more focus.
Yeah.
Okay, so now since we actually on the topic of shonen, let's talk about the cliches of shonen.
Yeah, since Naruto is almost over, I heard the fillers are coming back May 28th, so that probably get more.
Yeah.
So that's about to be over. Bleach's been over for a minute. I don't know about One Piece. One Piece is just doing One Piece. I'm not really sure about that, but I think.
What do you mean? Anime or manga?
Anime. I think we need a new shonen anime to for the next generation, because we had Naruto, like the generation before us had Dragon Ball Z, and we're sort of like caught on to it a little bit. But when kids around either 10 or 8, I want them to have a show, like a shonen show, to come over to like around the world, so they can be more involved in anime like how we were. So yeah. I just want a new show to come up and not feel the shonen stereotype, just try to switch it up a little bit, so
it can be perfect. I think actually there is actually a manga called Boku no Hero Academia that they're doing very well in Shonen Jump, like very well, like it's really like taking for fourth place and stuff. So I really think that in 2 years or that we can actually get an anime of Boku no Hero, and I think that would be the new anime that people will actually consider one of the new big three.
Yeah, because at first I thought Seven Deadly Sins is going to be the next big thing, but it turns out it was sort of a seasonal thing. So I'm like, okay, so like what now? Since Seven Deadly Sins was really good, I really enjoyed watching it.
Yeah, so Seven Deadly Sins is really good. People say it's like how fairy tale it's like the good fairy tale. Like the good writing of fairy tale.
Yeah, I don't think Seven Deadly Sins can get even like worse than fairy tale. They're on their own like level of like shit. Seven Deadly Sins can never go down that path unless I don't know. Yeah. I can't think of anything right now, but at least it does something horrible. But as of right now, it's doing really good. I heard some side stories is about to happen. Something about Bane, I think, or whatever.
That would be actually be pretty cool to watch.
Mm-hmm.
Like Bane backstory. That would be cool to watch.
Yeah, he's one of my favorite characters, along with I like King. Meliodas is he's alright as a main character.
Typical main sorcerer character.
Yeah, the side characters, his team brings it all together. If it's just him, then it's like meh. But since he has his whole team, and I think there's one more person who's missing from the group.
I don't remember the name, but I think one more. I think it's a woman or maybe.
Yeah.
I don't remember pretty much, but so overall, I think Seven Deadly Sins and it shows really the example of how to do a generic shonen, but in a really good storytelling.
Yeah, that could be like an example for like the next shonen. Oh, you gotta make it not exactly like it, but just like the same formula of how a shonen anime should be, instead of like the classical like Dragon Ball Z, One Piece, Naruto, Bleach. Gotta do something better. This is gonna be a carbon copy of the same old thing, and people will watch it, but it won't be as good.
Yeah, I think. Like for the next generation, I think shonen should be like almost like a sinning, like almost, but not like hardcore sinning, because then it won't be actually a sinning, because like people always will remember Full Metal Alchemist, for example. That is a sonnet that you can't even think of a sonnet. Like if you watch it for the first time, you're like, that is actually a sonnet? No way. So I really think that we should get more animes like Fullmetal Alchemist.
Yeah, and for the seasonal part, since seasonal and shonen have their flaws, but from what I've been seeing from a lot of seasonal anime, it's just been not the same, but it sort of has been, yeah, like their romance side, their action side, their okay side, and there's like their corny side, like Trigun X. But each season or each year they have like their big one, like 2012 Sword Art Online, 2013 Attack on Titan. 2014 was Tokyo Ghoul and a little bit of Parasite in there. But I want something, you know how like something classical like Death Note or like Code Geass is what I've been hearing about. They should be.
We should actually get more anime like that, like this year. I think we should get one,
Yeah.
maybe.
Since I'm just tired of the whole the same stories about how like, oh, romance side there's either a girl, boy, school setting, something happens, and 12 episodes of that, an action one, something happens, 12 or 24 episodes of that. I just want something that sticks, and that say when somebody watches it, like, oh, I can get into more anime because. I guess show just like this, how like Death Note was, and that's like that was a seasonal on how that became like bigger than it was, and since all these years passed, people will still be talking about it, and how it's like one of the best shows out. I just want something to come up out of Japan that goes worldwide and people to enjoy it, and other people to bring it back, bring other people who gave up on anime to bring them back into it, since. It will show that oh, Japan is not doing the same old rehashed cliche romance action stuff. They have more ideas up their sleeve, and it will be perfect for this generation and after the next.
Yeah, okay, but here's the thing, like, I think the next big anime that will actually will make it worldwide, it won't be a shonen. Like, I'm thinking that if we want an anime that would break worldwide, we need a seinen, a good seinen, like manga. Like, I think, perfect example, I think, like, have you heard of Vagabond?
Only
The manga?
only from you, I only heard about it. I seen it on my manga app. I seen it came up.
Yeah, so I think Vagabond, like, if a studio good, like, I think Madhouse will pick it up and make it to the fullest potential, because Madhouse, they also did the Death Note. So if they will do the same thing that they did to Death Note to Vagabond, if they will pick it up and license it, I think Vagabond can be the new big anime that will actually break out, if some studio will actually pick it up.
But can you give a quick a summary of what Vagabond's about?
Vagabond, like, I actually only read like two chapters, because I want to buy it in volumes and not read it online. But from what I can tell, it's actually an historical manga, like fiction, historical manga fiction about the life of Himuru or Himura. I don't remember the name, so don't like be angry at me about it, because I don't remember the name. But it's like about his life of a samurai that actually really go really go from down to up. But it's really, really good from those two chapters and the art of Vagabond. It's like one of the best art in manga, even today. Nobody can almost beat it. I think Berserk can beat it, but Berserk is like, you know, it's not almost coming up right now. But I think Vagabond is really, really, really the best manga right now.
Okay, so mostly about a samurai who, I guess, like in poverty or not doing good financially, and he comes up in the world.
No, it's almost like a tragic war beginning, like.
Okay.
Yeah, but that's pretty much it about Vagabond, because I don't want to say more, because people should really read it. You should all read it, from what I think.
Yeah, I really like manga with good artwork. The best artwork that I've seen in manga is, it's called I Am a Hero. It's a zombie manga.
Oh.
I think it's if it became an anime, it will blow High School to Dead out of the water. It's that good, from in my opinion. It doesn't start off like fast pace, but it steadily grows up. First, you learn about the character named Hiro, and it's the character development. It builds up, and then the zombie outbreak. It goes like step by step. It goes from people talking about it, that if you get bit, then people have been acting funny, and then he just been like on the Oscars stuff. Like, okay, I won't. And then. It builds up, trying not to spoil anything, and then out of nowhere it just like it booms, and then I don't know, you're just reading it, and then I marathoned it like a few months ago, and then all of a sudden I was caught up, and yeah, it was really good, like one of the best zombie mangas that I've like really read, actually. I think it's only that in High School of Death, from what I know, in the little zombie category.
Okay, so I think I have actually one more manga to mention, which I think it can be the new One Piece of Seinen, like the new One Piece of Seinen. I think this manga called Vinland Saga. It's a manga about the Vikings, and it's really, really awesome. The world. It's really good. It's like almost the world of One Piece, but like in a realistic way.
Is it a pirate really, based or what? Viking? Is it a Viking or pirate based?
Viking. Viking. It's like the next level of pirates. Like if you think pirates are bad, like Vikings are taking it to a whole other level.
Oh, okay. Is there like, there's like special powers, or no? Is realistic?
No. It's realistic a bit. I can say it's almost realistic in a manga sense, because the main character he actually have like a speed. He's really fast. Like for him, is really fast. Like he have a huge speed.
Oh, okay, yeah. I haven't really seen any Viking type manga or anything, but that's one of the things that I like about manga, is that they have a lot of different varieties of different like stories. But like since anime takes really long time to make, and manga like is quick, just like that. So there's way more manga than anime, and so they have more time to think of different like stories and you know, like whatever they can come up with and make it a good story, then you got a manga right there.
But still, like every mangaka want his manga to become an anime.
Okay, I guess we can start off with the, like, if people just started watching anime, and then people will probably recommend like an action show, like as of right now, probably say like Attack on Titan, really.
Yeah.
And it maybe could be a good idea because like, people are more drawn to like the majority of people are drawn to more like action and violence than let's say a romance anime because they show like a person like a teenager or whatever like a romance anime like 9 times out of 10 they probably won't be like oh this is what anime is about it's like cheesy wait till 26 yeah. whatever 25 episodes until I finally say I like you they probably want something to be like to grab your attention more it'll be like oh this is what anime is about and they have like a lot of more like or really a lot of other series that are just like it with the action sense I'll probably more get into anime way more than watching another romance or sci-fi type
anime. Yeah, but I actually think that if you actually recommend an anime to someone, I think don't recommend like the big ones like automatically. Don't do it. I think you should recommend your favorite anime first.
Mm-hmm.
Because then, what could you actually tell from your friend that if they actually like the same anime that you are, then you can tell them like what animes will actually he will like.
Yeah, because if you recommend your favorite show, since that show brought you into like becoming an anime fan, you get that feeling that when you watch it and when you finish it, you'd be like, oh, that was like a really good show. I should recommend this to people who never heard of it. And then they probably maybe get the same feeling that you had. And it will escalate to them being just as good of as a anime fan as you are. Since there's a bunch of shows that I've seen that gave me the same feeling, just as I said before we started recording, Kids on the Slope, after I marathoned that for like 8 or 9 hours sitting in my chair just looking at the screen. It was, after I finished it, it was really good. There was like a little bit, like a small tiny flaws here and there, but as a whole series, it's one of those iconic shows that not people really talk about, but it's one of those hidden gems.
From what I actually heard from you, that Kids on the Slope is really like a gem, from what you said. But for me, I think that the real hidden gem of anime, like now, but now these days, it really is Full Metal Comic Brothers. I know it's popular in that, but it's not popular enough. I don't think it is popular enough. I know that every anime fan will be like, of course it's popular in that, but like for new people, I'm talking about, for new people who look at anime, it won't be Full Metal Comic Brothers. It will be Bleach, Naruto, Dragon Ball Z, Fairy Tail, and that. It won't be, oh, and of course Attack on Titan, but it won't be Full Metal Comic Brothers, and I think Full Metal Comic Brothers should be the go-to anime, like for first timers.
Yeah, I see where you come from, because when I saw Brotherhood, it had things that Naruto, One Piece, Bleach didn't have. They didn't have it didn't have like 200, 300 episodes. It didn't have any like big 20 to 30 filler straight. It had a plot, it stuck to it, and in between there's some enemies here and there, but the character development, which I really enjoyed, and it just became one of those shows that, oh, I need to find more shows like Fullmetal Alchemist, and sadly there's not really a lot of shows like that, since it's still a shonen, actually.
Yeah, and not many, but there is some, but not many as you actually think. Like for example Berserk, like my favorite manga of all time, Berserk, the anime of it not really good, the anime And there was movies. They don't really capture the manga from what I saw, and I really wish that, because I know Berserk can be the best anime of all time. It really can be, but I don't know why some studios like want to like skip part of anime and that. It's really like, why are you doing this? Why are you ruining the perfection you have? Like, it's really weird from what I saw in some animes that adapt manga poorly.
Do you think it's because of the age difference, since it came out like before, really, when anime and manga was like as big as it is now? I think if Berserk came out like around like 4 or 5 years ago,
Oh,
yeah, I
for
think
sure.
it'll be maybe since everybody will be on it.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Like last year, for example, Parasite, the manga is from the 90s.
Yeah.
Like Parasite got its anime only last year. So now it's like, okay, if Parasite have it, why Berserk couldn't get that? Like, why? I don't get it. Like, I know that Berserk have like an anime and two movies, but it's only focused on one arc, which is people say, which I think too, it's one of the best manga arcs of all time. But there is more, and the anime and the movies didn't explore behind that, and it definitely goes for other mangas. For example, there's a manga called the Breaker New Wave, The Breaker.
I stopped watching, I started reading it like 2 years ago. But overall, the artwork and everything, the story, I really enjoyed it. I just it's one of those times when you read it, you just stop reading it for some reason.
Yeah. From what I think that, for mangas like The Breaker and that, like that is why animes for. That is why I animes for. Like the accent, the atmosphere, it will be better on anime. Like on manga is good and that, but on anime, if really a studio would adapt it really good, it really can be a good anime.
There's plenty of underground and mainstream manga that's going around that if it becomes an anime, then it will be,
Just blow up.
yeah, it'll blow, exactly. That'll probably be the next thing that'll probably be the next generation into anime, 'cause I.
Yeah.
But
For sure.
sometimes it doesn't really work out as well, because I read Akuno Hana like a few years back, and it became an anime 1 or 2 years
Yeah.
ago, and people didn't like it because of the animation. It was too a little bit of like chalky and too realistic with anything, but people didn't they didn't really enjoy that much. But it didn't really follow that manga that much. But overall, it was still good though, but people didn't really pick it up as much as I hope it would.
Yeah, because I actually was like that before. I was like, you can call the animation guy. That I was like, if it doesn't have a good animation, I will drop it. Like people are like that. Like some animes have like a different art style and that. Like for example, Ping Pong, the animation, like last year, I think, from what I watched, like this anime is really was one of the best sports anime of 2014. But people would not watch it because the art style, because of the animation, was very weird and not like anime is, if you can say.
Yeah, this is gonna be my last point that I'm gonna make before we wrap up, is that I had the same I thought the same way as you, but instead of anime, I thought the way as manga, since the artwork that I like really good artwork as I read manga, but you know how when you watch like read like a romance manga, it has like those pencil like those really thin characters,
yeah,
and like you have like a lot of that like in yaoi and yuri sometimes. Right, like those pencil sketch sort of kind of characters, and it sort of throws me off a little bit. I just want like a clean, crisp artwork, just like in I Am Hero and other mangas that I enjoy. It's sort of it throws me off a little bit, and I end up just stop reading it and hope for it become animated, probably animated better than the manga was. But yeah, that's one of those like little small pet peeves of mine.
I actually was like that too, but of course, until last year that I read Berserk, like after I finished Berserk, my manga view was different, like and same for anime, because before I actually watched Berserk or read Berserk, I always was thinking like, okay, first of all, animation and then story. But then, when I read Berserk, the artwork was like perfection, it was godlike. So, and then of course, the story was amazing in that. So, and then I actually changed my view around it, around everything. So now for me, it's like, story and then animation for both manga and anime.
Yeah, same.
Yeah, so I think that is enough because I think we almost went overboard of the time, no?
Yeah, we're at 59 minutes.
Yes. So let's wrap it up. So anyway, guys, so it was really fun to talk about these topics, except of course fairy seed, yeah, that is the name, not fairy tale, fairy seed.
It doesn't deserve to be called fairy tale anymore.
Yeah, it's not fairy tale, it's fairy seed, motherfucker, it's fairy seed. Yeah, but anyway, guys, you know what to do. Tell us what you thought about all these topics that we talked about, and of course, like the video and that.
Yeah, guys, same as always. Like, subscribe, comment on if you have any questions, concerns, or just want to talk about the topics that we talked about, and we'll respond back to you, and thank you for watching After School, After Story Podcast. Yeah, it can work both ways. I just got like done like school, so you know, After School, After Story. It works both ways, but yeah, thank you for watching episode 2 of After Story. Podcast.